Hey everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I'm gonna do another design tutorial. It's gonna be for this design right here that I made for the beaches prompt with my design with Detour. A lot of you have asked how I did this. I'm gonna show you step by step everything that I did from getting the graphic in ChatGPT all the way to the end and uploading it or making the upload, the PNG for the upload in Affinity Designer. So let's get to the internet right now. I'm gonna show you, we're just gonna jump into ChatGPT. I'll show you step one on how to get this graphic. All right, so here we are on ChatGPT. I'm using StickerWiz. It's one of the GPTs here. You can get there by exploring GPTs and then type in StickerWiz. I believe that works. Now I am on the paid plan. So there it is right there. StickerWiz, there's a bunch of them actually, but you can pick one. And then when you use it a lot, it puts it on the side here, which I have. So you can see this is by ChatGPT. If you're trying to use this for free, you may not have access to this. And again, you don't have to use ChatGPT. That's just what I used. You can get your backgrounds from Canva. You can get it from Vexels. You can get it from Kittle. Wherever you get your graphics from, you can do that. I'm just showing you where I got mine from. And so here it is. Let's go back a few days here. The beach sunset sticker. You can see I did a bunch here. You can see all of these. The one that stood out here was this one. And I had to go through a few of them. I said a scene of a beach in Cancun and gave me the circle one. And then I said make it wider and it made it this wide. This one's actually pretty cool. Then I wanted to do more realistic, and then it gave me this one. And this is the final one that I did. And if we go to this, you can see a vibrant color illustrated. This whole thing is kind of what we're doing. So I'm going to copy this and we're going to see if it can do it for another city. So I'm going to hit copy. We're going to get out of this and let's see how cool it is. I'm going to just go back to StickerWiz here. I'm going to put in the thing, and let's say we want to, for this thing, we got Cancun. It's three letters on top, three on the bottom, so six letters. So let's try something with another six letter. I'm going to do Havana. There you go. And is that the only place? Yeah, I think Havana has palm trees and skylines. Well, not really sure, but I'm pretty sure. Let's do this. And it's going to take a little while, so I'll come back and show you what it looks like. Okay, here it is. I think this one's even better than the one I did for Cancun. Let's take a look. Wow, check that out. That's really cool. So you can just swap in different cities in there, six letter cities, and come out. It would come out really cool. So I'm gonna download this one and I'll show you exactly what I did. So we're gonna do the same thing that I did with the other one, and that is upscale it. So I'm gonna upscale it just so it's just a little bit bigger. Right now it's 1024 by 2024, and we could scale it up and it'll be okay because it's not the main picture, but I'm going to show you exactly what I did, and that is I upscaled it. So here I am in dgb.lol. I'm going to hit the AI image upscaler just like that. I'm going to drag in the thing that I did, the Dolly for Havana this time, and I'm just going to pick in six sharp right there. You could pick any one of those. There's a whole bunch. Actually, eight is pretty cool too, but I'm going to use six and sharp, and I'm going to hit submit. Now this is going to take a little while, and so while this is going, I'm going to show you how I did the other one in Affinity Designer, but we're just going to wait a little while. You can see I did a bunch of these other ones for mine. I use it a lot, but this is going to take 36 minutes. We're not going to wait 36 minutes for it, but I'll show you what I did once it comes in and how I bring it into Affinity Designer, and we can do the whole thing in there, and then you just do those steps, but do it with this updated, this upscaled version of the design. All right, so here we are in Affinity Designer. This is the actual file that I did, that I used, and you can see these are the finished versions, but don't worry, we're gonna go step by step. But first, if you never use Affinity Designer before, you would go up here, hit new, and then you're gonna pick one of these. I already have my preset to 4500 by 5400, If you don't have that, you can type it in. You can type in your width and height and then hit create right there. And then it will do a blank one. It will do this, but just with the blank artboard right here. And I just copied these artboards and made it bigger. Okay, so first thing you're gonna need to do is make it this big. So this font right here is Impact. You can see I-M-P-A-C-T right here. And that's a free font that comes with Affinity Designer. You can find it on Canva as well. It's very popular. But the reason I picked this one is because it's really thick and it's kind of close together. So just pick any font that's really thick. What you want to do is kind of have a taller font, not a wider font. And then it needs to be really thick because you want to fill this thick space with the picture, right? So it can be Impact, it can be something else. It just needs to be really thick. And then you do the same thing with the other one. So you split the six letter word into three, right? Cancun. We could do the same thing with Havana, right? So let's do, if I did, all caps, by the way. So hit down the cap locks, Havana, right? Like that. So we want to get them as close as possible, like that. And then if you need to move it even closer, you can click right there, hold down Option and left arrow, and move these even closer so they kind of touch here. Almost touch, right? Because we kind of almost want to make it like a black square. So you want to use letters that kind of fill up the space. A J wouldn't be the best letter to use. An L wouldn't be the best letter to use because they're bigger holes. So you're trying to use the letters that fill up the space. That's just a tip right there. And so that's how you would do that. Okay, so the next font that I use is this one. It's called Deadstock. This is not free. You can use another script font, that whatever script font you like, but I like this one right here. It's on the internet. I'll put a link in the description. It's not an affiliate link, but it's I think I paid $34 for this one, but it's a great font. I love it. It's very retro, fits a lot of 70s, 80s kind of stuff, more 80s, I believe. Like Karate Kid 80s, that kind of stuff, and it works really well. All right, so now that you have these in this size, you want to kind of fit the tall rectangle, right? We're going for that. So the next step is to convert these to curves. The reason why I want to do that is because I want to make this whole thing one thing, and we're going to drag the picture or the graphic into it. So let's do that. I'm going to do it with this one right here, just so you can see. So this one, I'm going to convert to curves like there. So now it's not text, right? You can see I have its points, right? Okay, so we're going to click on this one and this one. You can see they're grouped here. I'm going to ungroup them. So let's do this, ungroup and ungroup this one, right? I'm sure there's shortcuts for that. And we're going to click on all of these. And instead of group them, we're gonna do this right here, which is add. So they're all gonna be one curve. You can see that it's one curve. You can still click on it individually and kind of move the curves if you wanted to, but we're not gonna do that. We're gonna add the graphic to this right here. So let me get the graphic that we did. This is gonna be the smaller graphic, but you're gonna do this with the bigger graphic after it's been upscaled and everything. But we can do the smaller graphic just so you see how it works. So here's the bigger graphic. I'm dragging it from my downloads, or the smaller graphic. The bigger graphic is gonna come in really big, but we're gonna stretch this one, and you may have to stretch the other one as well, but you can see it works just as well right here. And we're gonna put it over like this, and you can see right here in my layers, it's right above the curve. So all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drag it into the curves like that. And there you go, it's that easy. Right, so you can see, and we can move it around too. So if you don't like this where it's at, click on here, click on this one, and just move it around. You can see maybe you want more of the hotels, maybe you want more of the trees. Just be careful about the white outline. You see that white outline there? You don't want to put that in. So you maybe you want more of the trees here, like this with the birds. That's fine, right? Whatever you want to do. I like to kind of go mid and have the trees and the hotels and the beach line, shoreline. So wherever you find yours, that's where you want it. Okay, so now that we have that, we're gonna copy the curves to give it that outline. Then the next thing is this outline right here, right? So let's just copy that. We're gonna hit Command J when we're on this curve and we go like that. And we don't need this anymore, the picture, so we're gonna take that out of it and delete it. So now we have this curves in the background. And what we're gonna do is we're actually gonna make two of them. So I'm gonna hit J again, and I'll show you why. So the first one right here in the middle, and we're gonna use this tool right here. It's called the contour tool, is it? Yeah, this one right here. Not this one with the circle. Contour tool, O. And we're just gonna make it a little bigger like this. See that? How I did that in black? That's really cool, right? Now we can change that color right here. So we can change it to white or blue or whatever you want, which is really cool. But we're gonna do it one more time, and that's this bottom one right here to give it a double outline. So we're gonna do it again and bring it out like that. Okay. And what this does is it can give us a double outline, and we can take this one and remove it from the background. So you can either have two colors right there, or what I did is I knocked that other color out right here, right? Now mine is a little thicker here. You can go thinner, whatever you want. I'm just gonna show you how it works. So if we grab these two and we hit group, and now we can see this one, the top one, we're gonna erase from the bottom one. So we just hit normal and erase, boom. Isn't that cool? Now you can play around with this with the contour, right? You can make that thick or thin, maybe you want it a little thinner, and you can come in here and make that thinner, whatever you want, right? You may have noticed though on my other one that it is a gradient. So what we can do is we color this bottom one a gradient. So we have a gradient tool in Affinity Designer as well. That's this one right here. You can see if we hover over it, it says gradient tool. And we're gonna go from this side to this side, right? And this side can be red or whatever color you wanna pick. So I'm gonna just go with red, like a rainbow, boom. And this side, we're gonna go blue, like this, whatever blue you want. I'm gonna go like this light blue. And in the middle, I think we did yellow. So we come in here, you know, make it some bright yellow thing. And so we have this kind of rainbow effect right here. So you can see it matches that one too. Now I made that a little thinner than this one, but that's okay. Same thing for Mexico. So let's come in here and use our gradient tool, and we'll do the same thing. So click on here, pick the color you want, like red. Boom. Click on here, click the end color that you want, which is blue. Boom, and click in the middle. You can have three gradients or whatever, however many points you want, you can add right there. There you go. All right, so the last step that we're gonna do is we're gonna put this outline around it so it kinda separates it from the top. You'll see what I mean. You can see right here, I did it in black. Here it's kinda in white. I'll show you how to do it. So Mexico right here, I'm gonna hit Command J again. And because this one is text, we're gonna do it in a different style. So we're gonna do the bottom one here. I'm gonna add black to the background. You can actually pick any color, but I'm just using black so I can see it. And we're gonna do the width here. See how that works right there? Now, we're gonna do the same erase from everything underneath. So these two will need to be grouped. Do these two first, and then these two will need to be grouped. So inside this group, we're gonna erase the outline of Mexico from everything else behind it, the Havana. So we're gonna go down here, hit erase, and boom. So now, when you have it on a black background, let's change the color here. You can see it's knocked out. Now it will look that way for any color. So if I made it like a dark red color, that would still work. If I made it a dark blue color, you know, it still work and so on. So again, you can play around with this. You can change the width of this line if you want it different. You can change the picture in the back. You can make as many of these as you want. Just use six letters, three on top, three on bottom, and make sure you got the right country underneath. Like you can see, I got Cancun now, I have Havana, I can do a bunch of other ones, and they're all different, right, depending on the background. And you can look for realistic pictures. This is just from ChatGPT, but you can look for photos. There may be some stock photography of the place that you're looking for. AI could do more realistic or could do more cartoony or whatever you want. Wherever you get this from, it doesn't matter. You actually don't need AI for this one, but I was using AI for this one, so really cool. So script font here, thick font up there, and I think you got it. So you can do all of this in Affinity Designer and have fun with it. Do different ones, and you can have a whole series of these. If this one does well, then make more of it and increase your chances of getting some sales. So one more thing I forgot to show you is how to export this. So let's go here. First thing I like to do is make sure the background is transparent, and you can just click on here, make it transparent. This is the transparent. So if it was black like this, you click on here, and then here, that makes it transparent. And then I'm gonna hit Command Option Shift S, and that brings up export. You can also go to File and Export right here, but I did the shortcut Command Option Shift S. And then make sure that it's selection only. So you'll see whole document, selection area, selection only, and all these. I do selection only, and I hit export. You can see it's 4500 by 5400-ish. Doesn't have to be exactly right anymore on Merch by Amazon or Amazon Merch on Demand. And I'm gonna hit export. And I can title it whatever title you want. This one is gonna be Havana, right? Havana. It doesn't have to be all caps. And then it's gonna go to my desktop. I'm gonna save it. And I'll show you the PNG file on my desktop. I'm gonna open it up. So here is the PNG file. You can see right there. And the gray means that it's knocked out. And you can use this on any of the print-on-demand sites, Amazon, Redbubble, TeePublic, Etsy, wherever you sell it. So there you go, that's it. That's how you do it. It's so simple how to do it in Affinity Designer. They made it so easy with the just dragging it in and the erase feature and the contour, and it's so cool. So just follow step by step, and this is really scalable too. You can use it for different cities around the world and just fill it with different pictures that match those cities. It's really cool. I think it's a great technique. If you want to see more design tutorials, I'll put this video right here, the playlist of all the design tutorials that I have. You can watch those, find something else that you want to learn how to design. Thanks again for watching, and as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.